Philippine senators slammed Chinese Coast Guard personnel for seizing and dumping food as well as other supplies of Filipino soldiers aboard a ship moored in Ayungin Shoal. Senator Risa Ontiveros called it despicable and callous. She says China must show a measure of good faith by reining in their Coast Guard if maritime disputes are to be settled. Senator Nancy Binay called the obstruction of aid an affront to international norms and human dignity. Senate President Francis Escudero, meanwhile, maintained all communication lines between the Philippines and China should remain open. A source told the Philippine Daily Inquirer the alleged seizure of supplies happened on May 19. On those days, the Philippine Navy performed an airdrop operation to the BRP Sierra Madre. Philippine senators welcome the ombudsman's decision to suspend Bamban Mayor Alice Go. Senator Risa Ontiveros says they received information Go tried to obstruct authorities' investigation into the raid of pogos in her town. Ontiveros insists Go undoubtedly has ties with pogos. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian called the suspension a move in the right direction. He said all government officials suspected of wrongdoing should be thoroughly investigated and held liable. Meanwhile, Senator Joel Villanueva reiterates his call to ban pogos in the country.
We laud the efforts ng DILG and even our ombudsman. But again, we call on our government agencies to step up their game. Us here in Congress, we have been calling for the banning of POGOs. We have been, I sound like a broken record for the past 6-7 years na asking the government agencies to look into this.
Philippines Solicitor General Minardo Guevara says the ombudsman's preventive suspension against Mayor Go has no effect on its own investigation. Guevara explained the OSG is looking into complaints whether there is legal basis to file a co-warranto case against the local chief executive. But to proceed with a co-warranto investigation, Guevara says they will need to investigate Mayor Go's citizenship as a ground for disqualification. He also admits they encountered challenges in gathering evidence for the case, as sources tend to give conflicting statements. The Philippine government seeks to commute the death sentence of two Filipinos in Brunei. Migrant Workers Secretary Hans Leo Kakdak said Monday this was communicated to Brunei in his May 29 visit to the Filipinos last week. The two are serving jail time after being convicted for murder in 2005 and in 2016. Kakdak says the clemency appeal is being finalized and is based on humanitarian grounds.
Patuloy ang pakikipag-usap ng pamahalaan ng Pilipinas at ng Brunei tungo sa kapakanan at mga kaso ng mga hindi lamang death row inmates kundi pati yung mga prison inmates doon, yung binanggit ko nga kanina, yung dalawa na life imprisonment pero dahil umabot na ng 70 anyos ay dinalapit na natin na magkaroon sila ng early release.
The Social Security System looks to expand its portfolio in the real estate investment trust space. The state insurer has so far invested some 6 billion pesos in REIT companies this year. SSS officials expect the move to yield better returns for the agency. Its bullish outlook on growth in REIT investments is anchored mainly on the expected rate cut by the central bank this year and what it cited as increasingly favorable market conditions.